In just 50 or 60 years, software has totally transformed the way we do all kinds of things, from our banking and electrical infrastructure, to how we connect with other people, to how we work and spend our free time. And what's especially amazing is that software does all that despite being full of programming mistakes. Bugs that compromise sensitive information, like private photos or credit card numbers, get a lot of press. But programmers are in a more or less constant battle against all kinds of programming mistakes. It's a really expensive problem, both in terms of its impact on the public and in terms of its cost in human programmer time. And really, it's not all of the programmer's fault, it's just really hard to write good code, especially because most software, and the way it's used, is changing continuously. New features get added, new users are considered, and new bugs are found and fixed. My name is Claire Leguesse, and my research group and I work on ways to improve software quality, especially by making automatic tools that can help programmers find and fix bugs in their code as early as possible. For example, one thing programmers already do to ensure software quality is they write tests for expected behavior. Programmers use tests when they're debugging, as well as when they're writing new code to make sure that it works properly. Then they typically save those tests and rerun them as the software evolves to make sure that new code doesn't break anything that used to work. So when a test fails, that often means that there's a bug in the program that should be fixed. And right now, a human needs to do that. My group and I have developed techniques that can take failing tests and automatically change the program to fix the corresponding bug. But it's hard to automatically modify code in a way that makes sense and is correct. Human programmers already don't always know for sure that a change they're making is the right thing to do. That's why bugs exist in the first place. So how can we know that an automatic change is correct, or that a human programmer might like it? We take a number of approaches to help answer these kinds of questions. One thing we've done is develop other ways to evaluate program correctness, like by automatically generating new tests, or by using logic to reason about what the program does, find errors, and then construct changes that are mathematically provably correct. We also study human programmers and the data they produce. Programs are usually created by a group of people who all work together on a shared code base. Typically, that shared code base, which is usually called a repository, also stores a history of information that can be really informative. For example, the history usually contains almost every change anyone has ever made to the program, along with a short explanation for the change. We can use data mining techniques over those histories to model the kinds of bug fixing changes humans are more likely to like and understand. We use those models both to evaluate changes and to automatically construct changes that humans are likely to approve. We've even done actual lab studies of humans as they debug particular kinds of programs to learn what kinds of problems they typically find most challenging and why. Studying how software is built is the key to building better software. Together, our work is allowing us to understand how programs change over time and how human knowledge can be automatically reused to help make programs better. It's leading us towards an automatic toolset that can be most useful to programmers, a toolset that will make our world a little safer, a little more secure, and a little more reliable.